Hello, everyone. It's time to take a seat with your dearly beloved and talk to yours truly, Dr. Yams. Motorcycling can be a great hobby, an amazing experience, and include some of the best times of your life. It can also be the cause of pain to your friends and family members, and even start some trouble with your significant other. Here at Dr. Yammy Noob's two-wheeled therapy clinic, we aim to resolve any of these issues. If she throws a fit, twist the wrist, and just go, my dude. Today, I'm going to go over one of the many obstacles that we as riders face, and that's our spouses, girlfriends, boyfriends, or whomever you lay down with at night and text. I'm going to give you 6 points of motorcycling in regards to your SO, and if they don't work, you might want to consider that single life. Number one, research. Before you jump into any heated discussion with your spouse, I want you to consider whose hobby it is. It is yours, right? So why is your spouse restricting you from riding or even getting into it? It's the same thing as saying you don't want your spouse to try scuba diving, skydiving, or even learn how to fly planes. Why? We don't know. You're allowed to try a hobby of your choice. If it's legal, ethical, and moral, then why not? Think about this before you lose sleep on being told don't do it. Look into why your spouse doesn't want you riding in the first place. Is their opinion their own? Is their coworker Karen, who tells her husband not to ride, the reason why you're being told you can't? Opinions don't matter, only facts. The biggest fact is that it's your life and your hobby. Now look, I'm not advocating blowing up at your spouse. You need to know what reasons they don't want you riding and then work on resolving those issues. If it's money, buy a used bike. Maybe she googled motorcycle and an MV Agusta ad popped up with an insane price tag. Maybe it's stories, or she's had a close family member get injured or even die in a motorcycle crash. Find out the reason and then start researching your response. The hard facts are there. Yes, motorcycles are objectively at higher levels of risk. Motorcycles are faster than most cars. There's an associated cost to enter the hobby. If it were the other way around, let's say your spouse wanted to get into competitive paintball and start off with a $2,000 worth of equipment, would you quote-unquote allow them? Would your opinion jeopardize the relationship? Why is your spouse being so unfair to you? A lack of fairness in a relationship? Well, that's a red flag. Now, do you know what isn't going to ruin a relationship? Winning a free motorcycle. That's right. Now look, guys, we might be talking about what your spouse might think of you going out and buying a bike, but one thing's for sure, if you show up with the free motorcycle, you can't go wrong. Now we've got 3 brand spanking new bikes added to our beginner bike giveaway series. Got a Triumph Street Triple R, a Yamaha XSR 700, and a KTM Duke 390. Head over to yamminoob.co, pick yourself a subscription package. Every dollar you spend gets you 10 entries to win, gets you access to our Discord server, and all kinds of cool stuff. I'm literally there in the Discord every day. Seriously, I'm there every day hanging out with folks and chatting with them. It's a great time. I really, really enjoy it. But if subscriptions aren't your thing, you can head over to yamminoobmerch.com, pick out a piece of merch, and every dollar you spend gets you an entry to win as well. So get yourself a hat, get entered to win a bike. It's a pretty good time. Now, number two, risk can be mitigated. Just like drag racing, shooting, and extreme sports, the risk involved in motorcycling can be mitigated. Statistics are out there, and yes, motorcycling is more dangerous than driving a car, but when you look into the crashes, you can make more sense of why it happened. During the weekday, 23.6% of all accidents from Monday to Friday occurred between 3 and 6 p.m. That's rush hour. Also, when school gets out as well. It's a very busy time to be riding, and when things such as school buses are slowing traffic down, mixed with people rushing to get home, not paying attention, the deadliest time to ride on the weekend is between 6 and 9 p.m., with 24.4%, almost a quarter of all the weekend accidents. The next worst time is between 9 p.m. and midnight, and I'm going to assume alcohol and lack of visibility becomes a factor. If your SO is really worried about your safety, that's awesome. It means that they actually care about you. No one wants to be with someone who's trying to take out life insurance policies and hope they pay out. On the other hand, no one wants to be in a relationship where the spouse won't let someone ride motorcycles. If it's about rider safety, that's normal. Plenty of spouses don't want to be the mom or dad of their children to be out riding around aimlessly on a crotch rocket and trying to be a street Rossi and leaving them to become a single parent. But telling them no isn't the answer either. How do we solve this? If safety is a concern, then wear your gear, plan your routes, be a fair weather rider if you must, but compromise your position a little just so you can ride. If you're the father of 4 toddlers, God bless you, then you probably shouldn't be hitting 180 miles per hour on your leader bike in the streets in a t-shirt. Speed on the tracks, not on the streets, my guys. Something as simple as a full face helmet can save your life over a 3/4 helmet. Slight changes in your gear make huge impacts of the effects of an accident. Having a padded jacket can literally save your shoulder or elbow as opposed to riding without one. Children need parents, so ride safely, guys. Tell your significant other that, and even go gear shopping together. Tell your wife that it costs more the better it protects, only if that's if you get better gear. If they still say no, that's a bit of a red flag. But now on to the next one. Money. Some of the top reasons for divorce include money or financial problems, so no wonder why your spouse is freaking out over you getting a motorcycle. If you're running a tight ship, then I can agree with them, and yes, maybe spending $5,000 on a motorcycle is a little too much if you don't have anything saved for your kids' college tuition, or if you're pulling money out of those funds to buy your sweet-ass leader bike. All jokes aside, a motorcycle is honestly going to put some more financial strain on you if you're not already feeling the pressure. Adding a bike is like adding a car, but you get no benefit because the bike is smaller. You're going to drop $50 on factory oil and a filter, even if it's only 3 quarts. It's pretty rough. You need to get your money in order, and then you should be okay to get your bike. If you're sacrificing something important to get a motorcycle, don't. Your kids need braces, they need school supplies, maybe your wife needs to see a specialist. I don't know your situation, but my advice is definitely have your life set up before you start buying fun toys like motorcycles. And honestly, guys, motorcycles are toys here in the US, so that is how I'm going to be talking about them. I understand that in other markets they can be a valuable source of transportation, but we are talking about the passionate, toy-like qualities of them. My advice to you is if your spouse is giving you trouble for wanting to buy a motorcycle, save it up and just do it as cash. Don't burden the household finances with another monthly bill in the form of a bike payment, and be ready to buy 1 year of motorcycle insurance just all at once. If you need ways to start saving, pawn or sell off junk you don't use anymore. Compromise with your spouse and say, I'm going to sell some of my stuff and then buy something that I want. If they don't understand that trade and demand the cash for the bank, that's kind of a red flag too. Number four, and this is a good one, include them. I don't know you nor your spouse, but I'm going to suggest that maybe you include them in your motorcycle interest. Maybe he or she will take the MSF course with you. There are plenty of couples that do it, both young and old. A lot of times, the most supportive of spouses will go to the class even if they only want to ride Pillion. Suggest it and see what happens. Maybe your spouse is worried you're going to be picking up some hot babes on your R3 while being fully decked out in the latest high-vis fashion. Who knows? But the more you include someone, the more they feel important and that their opinion matters, and the more they won't see it as some scary mystery. If they go to the MSF class, gear store, or even bike dealerships with you, that's a huge win. Having someone supportive is going to go a long way towards your own positive mental attitude, and it's a great feeling to have someone that's included in something support you in return. If your spouse doesn't go for it or just wants to distance herself or himself from you while you do this activity, not a good sign either. Number five, compromise. I guess if it comes down to it, a compromise is going to be the next best thing. In all reality, if everything comes down to this stage, then you know you're going to get your bike. Awesome. Except it's probably not the Panigale V4R that you wanted, but a 10-year-old R6 being sold on Craigslist. If you can get your spouse to discuss all their talking points about why you shouldn't get a bike, then work through them and work to compromise, you've pretty much already won. Sometimes you need a voice of reason telling you to not start on a leader bike. Some guys really needed a wife to say, hey Kyle, I'm going to kill you if you drop that $15,000 motorcycle. But instead, they were single and they looped the bike immediately after leaving the dealership with a 21% interest rate on their loan. Way to go, Kyle. When your spouse reasons about what you really need and not want, things might make a little more sense. It's really easy to say you need a 300cc, no, a 600cc, but maybe this cheap ZX9, or how about a Turbo Busa? Exactly. If your spouse can keep you hyper-focused on what you actually need and what you're gonna get, then you're all set. Don't agree to anything that makes you uncomfortable or is outside of your skill set. Explain that even with Bluetooth, you might not be able to take a call, or as a matter of fact, you probably shouldn't be on Bluetooth for a while if you're new. If your spouse won't compromise, then you're given too much ground, and that's also a red flag. Now, one thing to know here as well is if your spouse is worried about getting a high-powered sport bike or something like that, remember that naked bikes are kind of secret high-powered sport bikes as well. So you can maybe present to her, hey, I'm not gonna get this R1, I'm gonna get this much more reasonable and street-focused MT10. Compromise. Number six, consider your options. This is probably as deep as I'm gonna dive into relationships, but you really need to ask yourself where your relationship is going, if your spouse is preventing you from trying, doing, or starting something that you know you're going to enjoy. If you guys are only dating, get into motorcycling. If it's something serious, dig to the bottom of the issue. I'm not going to say get a couples counselor and start therapy, but it will be cheaper for you if you just move out, maybe. If you two are married and he or she is refusing to let you ride, we're at the point of borderline psychotic. If you've been counting every time I said red flag and are at 5 out of 5, then if your spouse refuses to let you ride, that's a 6 out of 6, and I'm not here to give you legal advice, but I want you to know that a loving and caring spouse would let you do as you pleased as long as it wasn't illegal, unethical, immoral, or involved cheating. any partner that's trying to control you is really not a good thing, in my opinion. If you didn't ignore your children for your bike and you come home in one piece and it's not hurting anybody. Motorcycling is something you can afford, something you can get into and be mature about, and something you really desire doing, then your spouse should be supporting you as you enter your two-wheel journey. If they simply won't give you the time of day or even mention it to you, you deserve better, my dudes and dudettes. And also, for all the squids out there that already have a partner that was cool with them riding and then they started riding together, that's the best of both worlds. It's honestly a lot easier when you've got two people that ride. Makes the whole thing a lot better. So, how many red flags did you count? Dr. Yam suggested that one or two is normal, 3 to 4 is an indicator that the relationship's probably not gonna last, and 5 or 6, well, a lot of people got on a motorcycle to get over their exes. Ever wonder how they became the ex? Now, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comments about some of your experiences with this situation. I hope you don't have many experiences with the situation, because that means you're probably in a toxic relationship. That's probably the last relationship advice video I'm going to give, as I don't feel qualified to talk about it. I'm much more qualified to talk about squids, dank nooners, and turbo boosts. Remember guys, I'm giving away some free motorcycles. Hit the link down below to yaminoob.co to check them out. Triumph Street Triple, KTM Duke 390, and XSR 700 will be given away. So hit that link and check that out. I'll catch you guys in the next one. See you later. Fact: the hippo Columbia are descendants of the 4 hippos Pablo Escobar brought over for his private zoo. After his death, the hippos were deemed too dangerous to move and have now formed a feral population over 60. Hippos are really scary, guys. Goodbye.